Hello, welcome to the full release of Warbeep. Sadly, the game didn't go much in terms of gameplay style, in terms of gameplay modes, and in terms of other stuff as well. I have to say that I really expected multiplayer from this game, also will play on major. Also expected a lot more diversity in the gameplay loop. Right now what you get is basically what you see. It doesn't change much, so the only thing that changes over time is how many units you have. So at some point you'll have vehicles like tanks, light vehicles, APCs, helicopters, and that's about it. That's the only thing that changes over time. Yeah, you have more stuff over here, the upgrades and other stuff as well. But overall, nothing really changes, which is the biggest problem. So if you play the game when it was first released, and if you play it right now, you don't see many changes, unless you go further into the game. But again, this game needs two things. One, multiplayer. Two, a more diverse gameplay style, more interesting campaigns, missions, more progression, more interesting progression and stuff like that. Otherwise, it's a 5 euro game that will probably keep you busy for 10 hours. I don't think people will play this for more than 10 hours. Of course, there'll be those people who really like the game and will play it for 25 hours, 50 hours, but... Also, the enemy grows stronger as time passes, so in the beginning, you'll use a lot of warpips. And I think the first 3 missions you can win just by using the warpips and only that, even though this is on major difficulty. So let's see what I want. I want warpips and kamikaze drones. Sadly, we'll have to do a little bit of a sidetrack thing. We'll go over here and then we'll... Is it worth it? Probably is not worth it. They have trucks over here. Let's go over this one. So the first part of the game you can really win it only by using warpips and maybe snipers or tacticians. The second part of the game you can win only by using Pumas, which is a truck with a machine gun on top, and the last part of the game you just have to use a lot of artillery. And that's about it. There's not much tactics or much... Spending the medals, you get medals, level 1. So at level 2 you get a medal. The medal you can spend either for advancing the rank, getting an extra slot, or getting 50 money. Then you also have this one. Movement speed, weapon accuracy, weapon range, and defensive bonus. So you just have to juggle those. Okay, so let's invest all of our money into, you know, making them go faster and reach the enemy base faster. Sadly, there is no way to tell if the enemy is stronger or weaker than you, and there is also no way to tell how strong the enemy will be in the mission. So I think it's kind of like a roll of the dice. And they also changed a couple of things around, so let me show you. You can also sell the units you don't need for war coupons, and with the war coupons you can buy stuff from the arms dealer, so... Sell. One war coupon. Arms dealer. Buy... buy them from over here. Also get details of their stats, their weapon use, carabine, the bio. It's very interesting, but again, it doesn't add much to the game itself. And I wish they would show you the stats without clicking the details, because it's stupid. I mean, just put another line over here or over here, just, you know, make the game a lot more smooth, make the UI a little better. I think that's one of the reasons I didn't like it too much when it was released. Also, over here we have upgrades. You get a little bit of money in the beginning, depending on your difficulty choice. If you play on the lower difficulty, I think you get 50 war bucks and you can get another pip slot, which is super, super helpful. But again, the upgrade system is not so well developed in my opinion, and I'll show you why later. Also, you see the length of the map, the cycle duration, and the spawn waves over here. This means the enemy will spawn more units during this period. Sometimes you can push through it, but most of the times you'll have to wait and survive. So, how much does that cost? As you can see, you need to wait a little bit of time before you can use them. think only the heavy gunner. The tactician is great, but no, actually I think I'll take the tactician. The pipsqueak, they're basically useless because of their accuracy. Compare that to this guy's accuracy, which is 2. So that means he has 2... He's 2 times worse when it comes to accuracy than him. And believe me, this guy is no genius either, but if you increase the rank, you'll get much more accuracy. It says small amount, but it's actually pretty big. Do I need base defenses, smoke grenade? No, the enemy should never come so close to your base. We'll use the sandbags if something really bad happens. So remember to look at the length of the map or the size of the map. The wormhole doesn't do anything special, just gets more troops on the battlefield. Sometimes you'll finish a mission in 5 minutes, sometimes it will be 10 minutes, so again, that's another random thing. Sure. And this is kind of like my tactic, 4 pips, 4 war pips in the beginning. Yeah, they have no chance, they're also standing near explosive barrels and the grenade will kill all of them, almost. The enemy wave is already approaching us, so the more you go, the... you'll be able to push their positions. Oh, that's a lot of tips. I'm trying to put a sandbag over here, but yeah, that will not be possible. Just believe in your grenade launchers. Oops, I should have gotten a tactician as well. Next time. For killing 4 of them at the same time. Yeah, I cannot put the sandbags over there. Okay. Let's watch increase the rank if we can. Hey, that truck is annoying. So we have to wait until the wave spawner is done. That was the artillery from the tactician. Artillery strike. And as long as the enemy doesn't get artillery or mines or other nonsense, we'll probably be fine. Okay, the wave is over. Now we can finally push. Just need to wait until the tactician decides to use the artillery barrage on this clump of units. Okay, rank up. We did lose 4 pips again, which is annoying. On this difficulty, I don't know, the difficulty is also not very balanced. You saw how easy the first mission was and compared this to that one. You get so many more enemies. Just storm them. I don't care. Wish you had more control over your units, especially because of the way the grenade launcher works. Yeah, as you can see, even one increase in rank means they'll become killing machines. Get one more tactician now. Okay, we destroyed that with the artillery strike. And now we can probably just advance. The enemy will also. So this is another problem. The enemy spawns in front of you and your pips will attack the base. If that happens, they will not react to the enemy attacking them and they'll just die. By the way, that's the sign of the artillery strike. I don't know, it says something for favor. We won this even though it was a little harder. Yeah, only 3 stars instead of... Oh, that's my lives. So I can only lose 3 times. War pips, oil derrick, perfect. I guess I'll play until I finish the first map so we can see some of the vehicles as well. Also, this bomb means you'll get more resources, so it will also show you'll get 1 combat coupons and 15 war bucks, right? This one is double that. Of course, the enemy will be much stronger. They have a guard tower. Wow, I never seen the enemy so aggressive in the beginning like this. So the guard tower is easy to kill with the drones. Let me get it like this. I don't think we'll get our base attacked. What else do they have? They have the gas pips, which are super super annoying. I need snipers to push through that. I don't have them. Oh, turret. Anti-vehicle. Cannot target infantry. Huh. Interesting, because I want it, but I don't want it. Sells money generating items. Well, to be honest, in the beginning that's very important. As you can see, this is for defense, which I don't really need. Usually we get a lot more war bucks on the easier difficulties. These upgrades are pretty good as well. I don't get a lot of war coupons, I guess it doesn't really matter. I'll just save my money for the extra slot in the beginning, because we want to finish the missions faster. Extra life. Will this be enough to punch through them? Yeah, I guess it will be. The gas can be annoying and the barbed wire will be super annoying. No, I think I will do this a little later until... I think I really need the snipers on that one. Yeah, if you play on that harder difficulty, it gets more interesting, but like I said, there's no progress, there's nothing, you just play and play and play. Okay... I don't know, I just love the tacticians so much. Warfighter, they have the warfighter and the walls. I need a little more firepower, but I'm not sure how I'll get it. Ah, you know what, I'll just use the heavy guy. He's a good guy. It's a little more tactical like this, but I think this should have been a multiplayer game, and yeah. Ask 5 euros for it, make it a multiplayer game and people will love it. You already have two factions, I mean, you have these guys and our guys, which are more professional, but these guys have the numbers, of course. So yeah, maybe the game will be developed more, otherwise, like it is right now, like I said, it's probably worth 5 euros for 10 hours of game time. No more nor less. So the zoom is quite nice, because you can watch them viciously murder each other. If they're in a defensive position, they'll stay there, and if you give them the weapon accuracy, it's even better. Defensive position, but they really don't need the sandbags because they can take care of themselves. Well, as long as there is cover on the map, that is. Okay, as you can see, they have the accuracy bonus. Okay, 4 more seconds and we're ready. Oh, they already reached the base? Yeah, I was expecting that. As you can see, we only lost because they were not fast enough to reach the base by a few seconds, which is one of the things I really don't like about the game. I mean, come on, don't make it so pinpoint accurate. We could have won right there if we would have been 5 seconds earlier to the base and the enemies didn't spawn. Okay. Also, sometimes just more about the flare itself. You don't really need all of the units they give you. For example, do you need the heavy gun? That's not really, like I said, the war pips, the Puma vehicles, and snipers, and some other stuff, and you'll be fine. Didn't even need the heavy gunner this time. Of course, later, things will get a lot more complicated later on, but it's okay. Great, now we can solve this position over here. Then we'll take that one and that one. So, warp pip, sniper. I don't have the heavy gunner, but I will take the drones because I want to destroy the guard towers with the drones. Other than that, I don't think I want anything else. Maybe, nah, they're useless. The pip squeaks are useless. 45, almost 50. So yeah, keep your money for the other upgrades. Now, do I want to take anything else? Let me see. They don't have anything particularly bad for me. We'll take the oil derrick as well. I don't think we'll use it, but we'll get to see it in action. Probably. Lucky skeleton operation. Sure, sure. My opponent will probably only stay the same, like this, 4 of the war pips. Which will give you enough experience to reach level 3 almost, because the enemies are cannon fodder mostly. And oh, I need to wait 1 minute and something for... Oh no, the tower is way be... Yeah, the tower is too much... I mean, this is the middle of the battlefield. The tower should be a little... They just killed all of my war pips because the tower attacked me, so I guess I should have waited a little more. Yeah, as you can see, the game is very unfair most of the time. They never say, wow, that was a great tactic. No, you'll say that was unfair. I guess I have no choice but wait for the war drones, otherwise I'll not be able to destroy the tower. I don't think they'll use their grenade launchers on the towers, I might be mistaken, let's see. Oh, but they do use them. Okay, that was a very close one. The drones are pretty fun, they're especially useful against the howitzers and some of the other stuff you encounter later. Okay, advance to the next. Oh no, there is no cover for us. Yeah, well. Can you kill the gas guy? We cannot kill the gas guy. Why is that so hard? Okay, defensive positions. Thank you. So yeah, I guess the goal of the game is to occupy positions that are pretty well defended. Yeah, the gas guys are a very big problem. Whoa, what exploded over there? I don't know, but let's take advantage of it. Yeah, on this difficulty, I don't know, the difficulty is not balanced at all. On this difficulty it seems like it's too hard in most cases, even for me, but I didn't play before the video, maybe only 20 minutes, kind of see how the game changed. But yeah, it's a kind of like a tug of war on this difficulty. If I lower the difficulty by one title, then things will be crazy. And because we were not aggressive enough, we actually lost the initiative and we have to wait until the wave is over. Okay, we're back to full strength. Oh, a drone would have been amazing over there. Someone use a grenade on that guy. Good thinking. Yeah, this is way too slow. So, like I said, you can just play it on the easier difficulty if you really want to experience the full game, because I don't think this will be very fun for a lot of people. I just wanted to see more tactical options, and you'll see them later when you get more gear, but overall it will be kind of like the same experience every time. Now he moved away. That's the only thing that are keeping me from winning this. I guess we can win when the wave is over. Yeah, defensive positions and he sits in the gas. I guess I should have saved for the world Eric a lot more, and I used too many drones. And now, as you can see, I no longer get money because... Well, because reasons, but... mostly it's because I am level 13 already. I guess I should have taken some base defenses as well. No, I'll not use that one. Yeah, let's just forfeit here. There is an unbelievable difficulty spike sometimes like that. I don't remember if we lose the pips here, yeah, we'll probably lose them. So let's use... yeah, I think this will be better. Let's also use the sandbags this time. I should have been more careful in the beginning, because most of the times you just want to wait, you don't want to... Yeah, let's play it more cautiously this time. The snipers cannot attack directly the enemy base, which is always kind of a problem. Lucky skeleton, we get another map. This map is actually a lot better for us, because look at how deep their tower is in their territory, not like in the beginning. Sure, we can do it like this. Now the oil, look at it. This is 5. Yeah, this is a lot better since the tower didn't kill our units in the beginning like it did on the other map. Oh, this is also a lot better looking battlefield. I guess we'll need the snipers at some point, or probably I should get one very, very early on. Since my units already reached the tower. Okay, I needed to set up defensive positions faster. And now we did. Look at those guys with the pistols. That's funny. This guy is amazing. It's basically one shot, one kill for him for the lower tier units, of course. So I'll defend it, and when the next wave comes, I hope I'll have 2 snipers. Do I want another world, Eric? Probably not. Kill that guy, he's so annoying. I forgot to take the drones, that was a mistake. See, everyone died except for the sniper. I should have taken some drones, that was a mistake. I guess now I'll spend all of my money on real soldiers. He's out in the open, that's not good. I guess the way you should be using these things is just by slowly pressing them a couple of times until you get the necessary kills or the necessary accuracy. The tower is annoying. Let's make them a defensive position over there. They look like they need it. Get the sniper, he's only shooting. And that's what I like about him. Yeah, the grenade launcher guys are annoying. I wish my sniper would kill them faster, but like I said, we need two of them. Okay, we're almost back to full strength. We also ranked them up, perfect. Let's put another one over here. They need a lot of cover to advance in this open field with the tower. Yeah, we need to push before they kill us with their gas. They're amassing quite a lot of units, sadly. I think I needed another oil there, okay, but it's almost impossible to push through the wave at this difficulty. That was a few good kills. I should have gotten another sniper. Okay, we'll get another sniper right now. I think with two snipers that's more than enough to shut down completely the gas from guys. Yeah, just go defensive a while guys. By the time the enemy wave is over, I should have full strength and then I can assault them. Come on, sniper guys. No, don't let him okay. They didn't let the gas guy shoot. You can also hopefully rank up to level 2 by the time they finish. This upgrade is super important. Their accuracy, if it's upgraded, it's much better. Sometimes they hit the same target, but usually they do a very good job at hitting different targets, the snipers I mean. Look at them go! Snipers and grenades still haven't destroyed the tower, which is a problem. And yeah, he just forces them out of the cover and then they die. Now, if I was playing on the lower difficulty, this would have been so much easier. Let's get another oil there. It doesn't seem like we can push through with this amount of income. And I don't want to get to the other wave. Okay, I'll probably get another sniper once we level up again, because this is ridiculous. We have the max number of snipers, now we can probably advance a little bit. Yeah, we finally are hitting the tower. And with surplus money we can either get another oil rig or we can just reinforce or even make sandbags. That will be for the rank up. Eagle Eye, achievement unlocked. Okay, now we can push kind of 100%. Tower is down, perfect. Full strength for now. That was a mine, I think we stepped on the mine. Come on guys, don't let up. Push more. We keep getting destroyed by the mines. But the snipers are holding the line very well. Almost. And once we get another rank up, we'll be able to fully advance. Okay, okay. Making progress. We killed the grenade launcher guy, but he killed us as well. I think we're finally going to reach the sandbag emplacement if we stop stepping on the mines. Okay, max rank. I don't think this ranks up. No, let's keep our money for the reinforcements or maybe another oil rig. This is so slow, yeah. We're finally reaching their defensive lines. Yeah, I guess I should just get another oil rig at this point. Can we get another one? No, we can't. We only have two positions. Really? You can only get two money generating buildings? That's interesting. Okay, full push. We are pressed by time, sadly. Also shows you their upgrades over there, so as you can see they have one and two upgrades. No. That's not good. They destroy the trucks and then their base. Come on, you're all already there. I just hope not a lot of them won't spawn right now and that will ruin my day. So close yet so far away. Now we'll lose this one, we cannot push more than this. I mean, if we kill the super gas guys in time, we'll push more. Yeah, this is a very long map. I need the vehicles on this one. It's way too slow for my troops to go from one side to the other. Okay. Come on, we have enough troops. Assault. Do your things, guys. Oh, they're still wanting to fight in melee almost. Do you want to kill them with your knife? Wow, that was so much pain. Yeah, sometimes you just don't get the units you need, especially on this difficulty. But the amount of things you got is amazing. The turret is decent. The base turret. But also got the scorpion peep, which will destroy any towers, any vehicles and any tanks or stuff like that. Also, more snipers. So yeah, at this point I think we have enough to assault the main island. Warpip. So they basically have nothing new over here. Let's look at arms dealer. Oh, I really wanted this guy as well, but no. So let me show you how it is to play with one single upgrade. I'll probably play more of this, I don't know. It's an interesting game, to be honest. Arms dealer, 6 coupons. Can I sell something? You know what? And a small turret. Sell them so we can get another of these guys. So right now, as you can see, it's 100 meters, it's cycle duration of 6 minutes and spawn is. So what do we need over here? Normal pips, tactician, and I think we'll just use the rocket to make this go a lot faster. You'll see how much faster it is with it. Should I use also sniper? Yeah, let's also use a sniper. But then I'll not use the tactician, really. No, let's do it like this. One tactician, one sniper, and the war pips. This will be a lot of support. And sometimes you just don't need this, but there's no way of knowing exactly what you need. Especially on this difficulty, like I said. Also, you can use the rockets from the beginning, which is great. Most of the times they hit their targets, I really want them to kill that gas guy. Oh. Beautiful and perfect. Okay, let's use all of them. And they're already ranked up. I really need that tactician right now. Perfect timing. Defensive positions, everyone, please. Sadly, we start in a wave again, which is unfortunate. Let's unlock the sniper. And actually get the sniper, more importantly. Yeah, the gas is super, super annoying. Let them... Oh no, we cannot advance in this stuff. Yeah, they destroyed everything. They killed our tactician really well. I guess he was caught off position. Yeah, grenade versus grenade. That's what you get. That's what you deserve. Also, we have the rockets ready again. Probably there's no point. Yeah, let's wait a little bit for the final rocket. We have two tacticians this time. And then we'll get another sniper and probably it will go a lot better. Well, I think you cannot solve them pretty easy right now. Oh, that was actually even better. Okay, advance then. We also have enough attack energy, or whatever you want to call it. Rush energy. But you don't want to get careless, because the enemy, like I said, spawns directly in front of you. And I hate this so much. It's so much easier when you have a vehicle or something that can push. Because the gas guys just come in your face, throw a grenade and... tough ties. Yeah, not much I can do about that. I lost my tacticians again. Because they prefer to be on the front line. Well, let's just use the rockets and push. I think we got this. I don't want to go into the other round, so let's just get all war pips. Because they can attack the base. The other ones are kind of weak when it comes to attacking the base. Much sadness. As you can see, it's only about a few seconds, which this is the reason I don't think the game is tactical at all, because the difference between winning and losing is only a couple of seconds, and you can clearly see how annoying it is. I guess I should have brought more snipers, but more snipers means more less attack units for me, level 40. Okay, the next unit I get will be a sniper, no matter what. Oh, Come on, you're attacking their base. Is this not enough? Come on, base is over there. Shoot their base. Saving the rest racket for no, I have to use the racket. Just attack it one more time. Please guys, you can do it. Sadly there's no cover over here, so sooner or later they'll just die. No, it's just annoying. I don't know what to say about this. On the easier difficulties is too easy, on the harder difficulties too, it takes too long to win. And sometimes you just don't get the items you need. I think the game needs a total rebalance and multiplayer, and then the game will be amazing again. And the difficulties don't mean much. If you want to, there's no real balance of the difficulties. I mean, you get this enemy lineup, but you don't really know how hard it will be to punch through their lines, and we almost punched through their lines and then they spawned, we died, and again and again and again, just because I didn't get any vehicles or other stuff. Probably I should have gotten the dogs, probably I should have gotten the heavy gunners, but again, it's all random stuff. It's pretty easy. Well, see you next time, bye!